For a second, let people come on. And let's see, yeah. Trying to get comfortable here. Perfect. All right, we got one person on, Miss Wendy. Hello. Good to see you. We'll wait for a couple of seconds here, a few seconds here, and let some people come on, and then we're going to get started. I'm going to have a quick word. We're going to pray, of course. So be writing down your prayer requests for later. Don't write them down right now because I'll probably forget them. All right, while we're getting ready and getting on, for those of you get about 3 seconds before people as they check out our video. Number one is, don't forget, Sunday we're kicking off a new message series that's called Ephesians. And really what it is, we're going to walk through the book of Ephesians over the next 9 weeks. What is amazing about that is that we planned this and prayed through this, man, way back last July. And here we are in the most unprecedented time of my life, I know. And what a fitting time it is for this series. And so I know you guys are going to really like it. So make sure you gather everybody together in front of your computer, your smart TV, your phone, however you're going to be watching us online. Be prepared for that. Okay, so we'll be doing that. And then don't forget, man, I posted yesterday, hey, take communion. And I didn't see anybody take communion. Robin and I posted on there. We were hoping to see more people do that. Hey, let's do that. Let's remember we talked yesterday about not getting focused on the negative of our world and culture and all that stuff. Let's not, and let's put our focus back on Christ, man. That's what's really cool. So anyhow, we got a couple of people. I'm going to wait a couple more minutes and then we're going to get started because I got a really good word, man, for you today. Miss Nicole, good to see you again. Miss Dolores, Pat, today. Give me a couple more folks. Oh, they checked in, they checked out. They come on, they come off. So I'm going to wait a couple more seconds here, and then I want to get started. I want to make sure I don't want people to miss this. This is a good one. Today, as you can see, still at home. We will not be changing anything as far as our worship and our, well, I say change anything as far as we're still going to have church service. All that's going to be the same, and so let me encourage you in that. So let's go ahead and get started as people are joining now, which is exciting. Man, go ahead and invite someone right now. If you know that, hey, maybe do a watch party. I think do that. Go ahead and watch this. Share the heck out of it because this is going to be a really good word. Yesterday, we've been talking about the 12 names of God, which is amazing. And a lot of people don't know these. Some of these you might have heard. You might have even heard me. But didn't know what it meant. And so I think it's really cool because all of this is over from the Old Testament even to the New Testament. And it's really easy to get lost and go, well, that's for the Jews and that was just for them. But as you're going to discover as we go through the book of Ephesians over the next 9 weeks, what's going to be really cool is that you're going to discover the one new man. And that is how the Old Testament and the New Testament, man, they match. They work out together. I know there's pastors out there who don't believe that. Believe that Old Testament is only for the Jews. The New Testament is for the Gentiles or the new believers. And I don't believe that. I believe that we have the promises of the Old Testament as well as the New. So with all that said, man, going into these names of the Father, man, is really cool because what it does is it really spotlights some of his characteristics. Today, we're going to talk about, Nicole, you said you wanted a notepad. You better have your notepad out today. Because today we're going to talk about another name, and that is Jehovah Rapha. Jehovah Rapha. Love that. Here's the way to remember it, okay? It's kind of silly, but I learned it from my pastor that called me into ministry years and years ago. Jehovah Rapha, he heals my kapha. Got that? I know, it's crazy. I know, it's laugh if you think it is, but Jehovah Rapha is the Lord that heals my kapha. So what does Rapha mean? Well, it means the Lord that heals. Actually, two words come out of this word Rapha, and it actually means to either heal, watch this, physical healing, mental healing, spiritual healing, and another one to restore. I love that. Write that down. Restore. So Jehovah Rapha means to heal and restore. The very first time we find it in Scripture, in my Bible, I hope you guys have a Bible, is found in the book of Exodus, Exodus chapter 15, and it's found in the verse 26. Now, I'll give you some backstory of the passage. The backstory is, the nation of Israel was wandering around in the desert Shur, S-H-U-R, they became very thirsty. They came up crossed a body of water, but the water was so bitter that they couldn't drink it. It was actually undrinkable water, all right? And so what they had to do was they began to panic and cry to God. And so what God commands Moses to do, he does something really cool, is he tells Moses, he tells Moses to throw this piece of wood into this body of water, and guess what? It made it drinkable. It made it drinkable. So this is where God responds to that. He said, then the Lord said to Moses, stretch out your hand over the sea that the waters may come back upon the Egyptians on the chariots. That's not the verse that I wanted. 1526. Oh, I'm one chapter back. Let me go one more over. There we go. 26. And said, if you diligently heed the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right in his sight, give ear to his commandments and keep all his statutes. Watch this. I will put, listen to me today, I will put none of the diseases on you which I have brought on the Egyptians, for I am the Lord who, here it comes, heals you. That word heal is the word Rapha. Again, the word Rapha doesn't just mean a physical healing. It also means a spiritual healing. We know that through Jesus Christ, he heals us. We also mean that a mental, we talked about some of that in Scripture. Matter of fact, lots of places where you'll see this word heal, the word Rapha, all throughout Scripture when it comes to healing. Why do I say that? Because right now we're living in a time of fear where our culture, man, is under a pestilence or disease or virus, whatever you want to call it. Man, and I told you yesterday, we don't really have to walk in fear, and we get to walk in peace, that shalom, because here's another reason. Because he is Jehovah Rapha. He is the Lord that heals. So when you get sick or when you have a disease, whether it be mental, physical, spiritual, even relational, man, he's still the Lord that heals. And I think sometimes, man, we carry a lot of this stuff around, and God's like, right here, I'm going to show you in the New Testament what they say about Jesus, starting all the way back in the book of Isaiah into the modern day gospel or into the New Testament, and you'll see how powerful this is. God is a healer. That's why he has that name Rapha. All throughout Scripture, you can look at it. Psalms 41 and 3. Write that down. Psalms 41 and 3. He heals us of sickness, right? Healings from mental affliction. Find that in Jonah chapter verses 5 through 7. What about spiritual fatigue? Have you ever felt just spiritually worn down and exhausted? Well, man, go to Psalms 23 and 3. Psalms 23 and 3. Man, God wants to heal through anxiety and worry. Bible, Jesus said, cast your cares on me, for I care for you. And that word care is anxiety. Cast your anxiety, your worries, all that stuff onto me. God is Jehovah Rapha, right? Jesus, and then you go into the New Testament. And in the New Testament, we find it here in Isaiah. First, let's go back to the Old Testament for a second, because I want to show you something. It's a prophecy of Jesus found in the book of Isaiah. And in the book of Isaiah, let me pull it up here, way about in the middle, it's Isaiah 61, actually towards the end, Isaiah 61 and 1, I believe that's my passage, yeah, 61 and 1, watch this, church, watch these guys. It says, arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you, for behold, 61 and 1, another chapter missing, I got to go one more over, I've been doing that today. All right, 61, right here, look, 61. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings to the poor. He sent me to heal, there's that word Rapha, heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty, or another word for liberty is freedom to the the opening of the prison doors who are bound. Verse 2, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God to comfort all who mourn. So we know that Jesus one day walks into the temple in one of the first parts of his ministry. He sits down and he opens and he opens up to Isaiah 61 and 1, and he reads this, and he tells the hearers of that, and he goes, today, this scripture is fulfilled. In other words, Jesus saying, I am the guy that this is talking about, right? So now, we see healing coming in with Jesus. Matter of fact, it doesn't take much, man, to go through the Gospels and look at all the people that Jesus connected with. And every time he came in contact with someone, they were healed, either physically or mentally, every time, whether it was a demon being cast out of them because of or disease or blindness or leprosy, loss of blood, all sorts of crazy stuff. Man, God is still in the business of healing. You hear that? He is still Jehovah Rapha. And now we have Jesus Christ, who is the Son of God. He is God in the flesh, right? And so now we have that. So if you look over here, Mark chapter 2, that's the New Testament, right? So Matthew, Mark, it's the second book. And I'm almost done here, and we'll wrap this up. Mark chapter 2, verse 17. Look at what it says. Mark chapter 2, verse 17. When Jesus heard it, he said to them, those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick, I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners to the repentance. The Bible calls Jesus the great physician. That's what he was saying here. He said, I didn't come for the healthy. I came for what? I came for the sick. I am a healer. He is Jehovah Rapha. He is God in the flesh, Jesus Christ, right? What an amazing thing. So no matter what we're going through in our society, man, it doesn't mean, now I'm not telling you don't go to doctors, don't throw your brain out. That God has blessed us with doctors back in that time. Matter of fact, Luke, did you know this? The book of Luke, and Luke, one of the authors, which many believe that Luke is the author of the book of Hebrews, but Luke was a physician. He was a doctor, right? So, and you never hear Jesus go, Luke, you're doing the wrong thing. You should just trust me. He didn't do that, right? Luke was a doctor. Jesus is the great physician. And the Bible says, man, if we'll trust in him, and it says that we'll call on him. 1 Peter 2 and 24, it's a scripture verse that I use a lot and in the New Testament, says that that he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities, the chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we're healed. Man, there's healing in him. And so whether you're sick, hey Bob, good to see you, brother. Whether you're sick, or whether you have a mental illness, or whether there's things, man, you can call on Christ, man. He is the great physician. So the word today, and the word of the name of the Lord that we're learning, is Jehovah, the Lord is, Rapha, the Lord is healer. That word healer doesn't mean just physical healing. It also means restoring. God will restore. Matter of fact, the Bible says that the Lord will restore what the canker worm has stolen. This restoration that God wants to bring upon to his people. God has healing that he wants to bestow upon his people. And it's just a matter of faith, a matter of trusting your heavenly Father. And sometimes he'll use doctors. You'll go to the doctor and you didn't know you needed something, and God will use faith and the doctors to heal you. Sometimes, yeah, God does it miraculously. You just call out to him and he heals you, right? Sometimes it's a process, right, of things happening. Can God heal you miraculously in an instant? Of course he can. He's God, man. He can do anything, right? But sometimes there's a process of these things happening. But he is still in the business of healing. And I just want you to trust that in that. We can have peace in this world that we're living in that's chaotic. He'll heal your relationships. Man, maybe you have a bad relationship with family or friends and all that stuff. He's a restorer. He's a healer. Maybe you need to be restored back to him and healed of sins and stuff. Man, he's a restorer. Back to you there. It doesn't matter. Maybe it's physical. Maybe you're sick and you just need God to heal you. He can heal you. Man, it's just a matter of trusting in him and having faith in him and using wisdom, right? Using wisdom. So that's the word that I want to give you today. So as we're going to pray here in a minute, man, we want to pray for everyone, and especially during this time that we're in. And that's why I've been reaching out to you guys every afternoon, because I know a lot of y'all are stuck at home and need a little word, or you need a little something. That's what I'm trying to give to you. Man, take this home. Study this out, man. Go on your own and take the time to study this out. All right. So if you have a prayer request, man, go ahead and put it down here. In the comment section, I'll take a look at it. We'll pray as we're going. But I do want to give you a remember, man, join us in Sunday morning right here for our live stream feed. Going to be talking about the book of Ephesians. Man, our very first message is going to be talking about who are you. I like that song. Who are you? Who? Okay, I don't get to join the worship band, but hey, there you go. All right, so who are you? Who do you say? Who does God say you are? You're going to love that. Very first chapter of 1. Matter of fact, here's what you can do. You can cheat a little bit. Go ahead and read the first chapter of Ephesians. Read the first chapter of Ephesians, and you can get started on that. Maybe gather the family and do that around you. All right, number 2, we talked about this yesterday. I want to do it again. And I love communion, because I truly believe that when you partake in communion, that really helps in the healing process. It really does, man. So I think you need to do that. Thank you, Michelle. Appreciate you so much. So, read Ephesians. Take communion, man. Gather with your family. Take communion. Take pictures of it. Post it online. Encourage other people to take communion with you. We took it last night. We're probably going to take it again tonight. Man, just to put our focus back on the Lord, right? Jesus said that to his disciples. He said, man, as often as you think of me, remember me, do this in remembrance, right? And so that's what we're doing. You don't have to be a pastor or a priest to do that. You can do it right there at your home. If you need some guidance in that and some instruction, send me an email at mike@epicliferal.com. mike@epicliferal.com. Send me an email, and I'll send to you kind of a sheet that I put together on how to do communion in your home, okay? So send that to me, and I'll get that to you, and you can have communion tonight with your family, all right? And then what else? Oh, yeah, prayer request. Anybody got a prayer request tonight? Maybe not. We're going to go, all right? So if you need prayer, let me know how we can be praying. And also, all these people that are watching, going to watch now, watch later, they'll be able to see those prayer requests as well, and we lift up a prayer for you. Praise God, okay? Nothing. Praise God. All right. Well, let me pray for you anyways, and then we're going to cut this thing short. We love you guys. God bless you, man. Keep fighting the fight of faith. That's what it is, man. And remember, we have Jehovah Rapha, the Lord our healer. He's in our corner. He's about us. Praise God. The Bible says all the promises of God are yes and amen. And so I believe in Jehovah Rapha. Praise God. Let's pray. Father, we love you so much this afternoon, and thank you for your healing, that you are Jehovah Rapha. We declare over our lives, over our in Jesus' name, that you are Jehovah Rapha. Lord, your word declares in Psalms 91, verses 9 and 10, that 1,000 may fall at our side and 10,000 at our right hand, but it will not come near us, our dwelling. So Lord, we just declare that right now in Jesus' name. Lord, we know this virus is out there. We declare healing of all of those men and women who have it. Lord, we pray for healing over their bodies. Lord, pray over all of those that we know that are sick, Father. We ask that you would heal their bodies right now in Jesus' name. And then, Lord, we want to lift up those who are far from you that need to be healed spiritually. So, Lord, we lift up those folks, Lord God, that you would use this time, the season that we're in, Lord, that you would use this season to draw people to you. Father, your word tells us that no man can come unto you unless the Spirit of the Lord draweth them. So, Lord, we ask in Jesus' name that you would draw people to you right now, Father. We pray for all of our parents and the schools and everything that's going on in our country. Lord, we just pray for wisdom, that you pour out your wisdom, Lord God, over your people and over those that are in authority. And then, Father, we pray for Sunday, that this Sunday, Lord God, we'll be able to impact more people online through our live streaming, Father, than ever before. And Father, we thank you. We thank you for provision to continue to do it. And we thank you for everything that you're doing in our lives. We give you praise and we give you glory in Jesus' name. Guys, I love you. Thank you for joining me at this time, man. We'll see you tomorrow, Friday. I might be a little late tomorrow because I think Robbie and I might be doing something, but I might do it on the road. How about that? I might be doing it on the road. I might have to take a step off the road and do it. But I might be going for a bike ride. But pretty excited about that. Anyhow, I love you guys. Pray for me as I'm preparing for this message on Ephesians. Read Ephesians chapter 1. Take communion. And we'll see you guys real soon. God bless.